This is PD Forrest, and I've just run back from the snow bank to do a review of the outdoor ukulele, the natural one. And it survived the snow bank. Isn't it great service that they'll deliver to your favorite snow bank near your place? You can pick it up anytime in the snow. Well, this survived, but actually the tripod didn't, that I was using to film myself. It stuck. I tried to hammer it and I don't know. So anyways, I recently had what you called UAS, ukulele acquisition syndrome. And ukulele players know what that means. It means you suddenly have to buy one. You see one, you want to buy it. So after I did all those reviews of those Martins, I noticed this outdoor ukulele, this clear one. So it seemed kind of cool. And it's a plastic ukulele, a composite bicarbonate, this type of plastic. It's very sturdy. And the company says this ukulele is ideal for backpacking, camping, snow sports, classrooms, and beginners. So I thought I would take a look at this. And first of all, it's made in Bend, Oregon. And we all know we have to get to Oregon, if you remember that old video game. That goes way back, that video game, Oregon Trail. And so it's an interesting thing that it's made in the States. It's almost like it's something that would have come out of the 3D printer, since it's all plastic. So we'll see how their competition goes in the future, because a lot of people are making plastic ukuleles now. Now, it's a 12 fret ukulele, of course, and there's a dot on the 5th, 7th, and 10th fret. The only thing I find strange is the 12th fret crosses exactly where the body meets, and it's kind of weird. You see another line through it, so it confused me the first few times when playing it. And it has a hollow neck. It's a hollow neck, and it gets wider as you go up. So it's best you play with your thumb behind. But it's hollow, but it doesn't go into the body, so it's funny. The one thing they should have done, they could have put a little cork here, and it could be like a canteen as well, so you could pour in water and go... See? That can be the upgrade, the canteen version. And here's what's really funny, the logo. Check out this logo. It's a deer. Now, let's see something here. Deer in the headlights. Oh dear me, it's got a red scarf. And it's very funny because that deer reminds me very much of Jägermeister. Look at the Jägermeister, it has a deer. And it's funny, so we have a deer there. So maybe there's a conspiracy to make you want to buy this and drink Jägermeister, which I rather like chilled anyways. But this is the first thing I noticed, the deer. And with the red scarf. And it cost $100, $125 in Canada, and there's dealers online, so I ordered it from Kingdom Outdoor Products, I think so. And they shipped it right away. They had really good service. So if you're in Canada and you want to avoid brokerage fees, I'd order from them, because I did. So there's a black version of this. This is Au Naturel, I call it. And it's not as clear in the ad. In the ad it looks really clear, but in here, It's a bit more cloudy, so I wish it was a little bit more clear. And the bridge is kind of non-adjustable, so you have to take the intonation you get with it. But this is a $100 plastic ukulele, so. And you have the Grover tuners, the friction tuners. A lot of new ukulele players will have a hard time with these type of tuners. You always sort of have to tune up to the note. And these aren't so bad, these friction tuners. And it's just the only thing on this ukulele, the tuning is a bit tricky. So some people suggest trying other strings. These are the strings, T2 D'Addario strings. And the key is to have a battery. Because a Duracell battery, this review, my Duracell battery, this review is almost like me promoting ads, but it's not really meant to be. This fixes all my ukes, powers all PD's ukes. Why? It's not really a battery, it's a screwdriver. When I bought a bunch of batteries, AA batteries one time, it came with a screwdriver, and I said, what am I going to do with that? And I realized it's perfect for my ukuleles. So when you want to adjust the tuning, if you find the pegs slipping, you can tighten the pegs. So I just keep this in my case. It's kind of cute, the phony battery tuner. Okay, so another thing about this uke, is that it's got a X on it, like X on the headstock, and it's got lines in the body here. And the funny thing, it has all these little circles. Like you see two dots here, two dots there, all these little clear transparent circles. And they're actually on the back around here too, and there's one there, there's all these crop circles, I call them. So this must have been deposited by a UFO, you know, the ukulele. This outdoor ukulele could have been left in the woods by aliens. So, and X marks the spot. Now, I left the original strings on here. Some people say to change them. I personally would leave them on. I've had this for over a week and been playing it, testing it. So, some people recommend changing the strings. Now, playability. This thing is very percussive in the sense like it's a chunk sound with every... So I find when you're using a ukulele, then you should take advantage of what it's best at. And it's a durable outdoor ukulele, they say waterproof. But it's got best good for the chunk sound. And the person, Gerald Ross, ukulele player, he did a tutorial on how to do swing ukulele. And I find that works well. So if you do... kind of effect. So I find it works really good like that, and it also has a very like a lot of noise up the string. So when I do my song Skeleton called Luronco, see, it has that great slide in. So it's a very percussive ukulele, I find. I mean, you can play some finger picking. So, and like other comments I've heard, you don't want to hit the strings too hard because they do sort of, the pitch goes up slightly, but I've found after a week I could get pretty used to it. And it's just you determine what songs on it sound best. Maybe not all the songs you play sound best. I mean, my song Paris in the 20s, we can hear a little bit of that. Back in 1922, when we met in Paris, ooh la la, ooh la la, I fell in love with you. Paris in the 20s, sabon, sabon, scoopy-dooby-doo. Paris in the 20s, sabon, sabon, scoopy-dooby-doo, scoopy-dooby-doo, scoopy-dooby-entre-nous. So you can see, I've played that on my Martin Cherry 3 before, and you can hear I'm playing it on this. So it's kind of not bad on there. So it has this great sort of 1920s, this swing sound, I find. And I saw a guy playing some clawhammer. I'm not very good at clawhammer, but you can see, you can work on that and get that. Now, is there any other comments? The action is very fine. When you're playing, you should always keep your thumb behind the neck, because it works better when it's behind, you're moving up. Intonation's okay, but you can't change it because of this bridge, as far as I know. And some say Martin's strings sound better. You just have to have a lighter touch on this ukulele. It doesn't come with a gig bag. And it came with this card. And it's funny, the card was bent. It's from Bend, Oregon, so maybe that's their trademark. And there's dealers for outdoor ukulele you can find online. And it does on the main site have strap buttons and passive pickup and stuff like that. So, now, I'm going to finish this off with a little bit of Dark Eyes, just to show you, like, if you're outside at the campfire, a folk song. And, enjoy. Oči čornia, oči jasnia, oči žlučia i prekrasnia. Как люблю я вас, какая я вас, знак увидел вас, давний добрый час. Outdoor ukulele. Like plastic ukes, You'll like this one.